Welcome back to the SEAM channel. Today we're bringing you the next installment in our Building UP 844 series. So make yourself comfortable and let's start the show. In this installment, we're going to highlight the machining of the cradle, cross ties, the front buffer casting, the fabrication of the equalizer bars and plates, and the assembly of the frame for our little engine's ALCO Northern. You may have noticed that it has been some time since our last series installment. Unfortunately, the project was delayed a bit as we waited for a foundry to deliver an order of cross tie castings needed to continue. These parts arrived in early October and work immediately resumed at Gemini on our 844 ALCO Northern. Before we get started, we'd like to remind you that a full photo gallery of the construction updates between video installments can be found on the Northern's project page at thesteamchannel.com. Here you can also find links to Little Engines and Gemini Industrial Machine. Without further delay, we'll bring you to the Gemini shop where Jason Johnson and Jason Drake were working on milling out the cradle slots where the water jet frame machined in our last installment will be attached. The next step was to mill out the rocker plate boxes on either side of the cradle casting. Jason made quick work of this process. With this completed, Jason drilled out the holes for the drive screws, which will attach the rocker plates. These parts will be fabricated at a later time. Attention then shifted to milling the cross ties. These are important castings which hold the locomotive together. The first step in finishing these castings was to face mill them to spec. We'll join Jason as he proceeded with this process. Yeah. Jason then repeated the facing process and milled the front buffer casting to spec. When this process was completed, the cross ties, front buffer, and cradle casting were blued in preparation of transferring the holes over from the completed frame sections. Here you can see the parts as they wait to be clamped up to the frame. We'll join Jason as he discusses the next steps.
Okay, here we have the cradle back here, all machine ready to go. You see the frame rails, spreaders, all ready to be installed, put together here. This is the heart of the whole locomotive. Everything's been machined, getting blued up, and we will assemble the frames and all the centerpieces, and then we will transfer punch all of the holes to be drilled and tapped on the centerpieces, and then the whole thing will come apart, remachined, and then painted and assembled one last time. Start it back there, get that lined up here.
Tap that one towards me. Towards me.
With all the holes transferred, it was time for the team to pull the frame apart so they could finish drilling and tapping the holes in the front buffer, cross ties, and cradle. We'll spare you all the additional drilling and tapping, but you can see the end result after the castings were all drilled and tapped. With these castings ready to go, focus shifted to fabricating the equalizer plates and machining the equalizer bar castings. These parts are from the third section. However, they were knocked out now, so the frame shouldn't have to be disassembled again. You can see a set of equalizer bars completed on the workbench as Jason finished up drilling out the final equalizer bar on the milling machine. Six equalizer bars are required for the locomotive, and you'll need to fabricate 12 equalizer plates. The exact specs for these plates are provided in the little engine's drawings for the ALCO Northern. With these components completed, Jason began the process of installing them on the locomotive's frame. Loctite will later be applied to these bolts to ensure they don't rattle loose as the engine operates. Once the equalizer bars and plates were installed, the team began the process of installing the cross ties, front buffer, and finally the cradle. With these components secured, the team was ready to bolt up the other frame sections into position. The cross ties and front buffer will also be painted black to match the frame.
These holes aren't big enough. We can drill these ones out.
As you can see, the frame section came together beautifully on our little engine's ALCO Northern. We'd like to thank Jason Johnson, owner of Gemini Industrial Machine, and his quality control manager, Jason Drake, for their fine work on this project. In our next installment, we will begin to tackle section 2 of the build, which will include the axle boxes, driver sets, crank pins, spring rigging, and other components to complete the section. If you'd like to help support this project, you can make a secure donation via PayPal. We will put our PayPal ID in the video description below, and you can also donate via PayPal through thesteamchannel.com. We'd also like to inform you that Little Engines has been sold to Jesse Banning. You can read former owner Mike Venezia's full statement on the transition on the Northern's project page at thesteamchannel.com. This transition will not affect our Northern series moving forward, and we look forward to working with Jesse as he takes the helm at Little Engines. Thank you for tuning into this installment. Keep the throttle open, and we'll see you next time.
Hi guys, thanks for watching this video here on the Steam Channel. Catch another Building the Northern installment by clicking on the video preview to the right.